Hello friends, welcome back to Shriji Classes, and in this video we are going to study oxazolidinones. Here the drug is linezolid. The mechanism of action: linezolid binds to 23S fraction, the P site of the 50S ribosome, and interferes with the formation of this complex, that is tertiary N-formyl methionine tRNA 70S initiation complex, and thus inhibits the bacterial protein synthesis. Thus, it inhibits bacterial protein synthesis before it starts. Next, we will discuss the antibacterial spectra. Resistant gram-positive organisms like MRSA, VRSA, VRE, and penicillin-resistant Strep pyogenes, Strep viridiens, and Strep pneumoniae. Second, it is active against resistant MTB and also on the Listeria, Cornibacterium, Clostridia, and Bacteroides fragilis. It is primarily bacteriostatic but can be bactericidal against some streptococci, pneumococci, and Bacteroides fragilis. Next, mechanism of resistance. Due to mutation of 23S ribosomal RNA, the enterococci develops resistance against linezolid. There is no cross resistance seen with any other class of antimicrobial agents. Next, pharmacokinetics. The route of administration: it is oral and IV. It is more preferred orally. Excellent oral bioavailability. It is partly metabolized non-enzymatically. Excreted in the urine. THF is 5 hours. No dose modification needed in renal insufficiency. The dose is 600 mg BD, that is twice a day. CSF penetration is approximately 70% and it has concentration independent activity. Now we will discuss the uses of linezolid. First, uncomplicated or complicated skin and soft tissue infections. Second, HEP, the serious one. Third, as a reserve drug for extensively drug resistant TB. Fourth, bacteremias. Fifth, febrile neutropenia. Sixth, wound infections. Seventh, VRE, MRSA, multi-resistant strep pneumoniae, etc. Being bacteriostatic, it is not used for enterococcal endocarditis. Eighth, complicated abdominal infections. At last, we will study the side effect. GIT side effects like abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Second, rashes, pruritus, and headache. Third, hematological manifestations. It is the primary toxicity of linezolid. Bone marrow suppression. On prolonged use, that is approximately more than 2 weeks of usage, it causes thrombocytopenia more than neutropenia, and also it causes anemia. Sometimes it also causes myelosuppression. The indication of myelosuppression is this: sore throat and fever. Fourth, optic and peripheral neuropathy on prolonged use, approximately more than 4 weeks of linezolid. Fifth, lactic acidosis. Sixth, it is a weak myo-inhibitor. Hence, it causes serotonin syndrome and also it causes cheese reaction. And now we will discuss the tadizolid, which is the second compound of the oxazolidinones. First one is the linezolid. And now we will discuss the tadizolid. It has strong inhibitory effect on staphylococci, enterococci, streptococci, including MRSA, VRE, and some linezolid resistant phenotypes. Tadizolid in the dose of 200 mg OD is equal to the linezolid in the dose of 600 mg BD for 6 days. Hence, tadizolid is the more potent one. Administered as inactive phosphate salt. The THF is 12 hour. Side effect: it causes less bone marrow suppression and less neuropathy. So here we completed our topic. Thanks for watching my video, and if you found it helpful, then please like, share, and subscribe.